This is Ritesh Mathur. Today we welcome you all to the interview section of RealtyMyths. We have with us Ms. Asma Javed, who has over 15 years of experience in retail and commercial leasing, and we'll be talking to her over the recent development in India about the retail and commercial leasing. She has recently joined ATS as the AVP Retail and Commercial Business Development. So ma'am.
Thank you, Ritesh, for the introduction.
As you spend most of your time into commercial real estate leasing, how do you see the growth potential in the times to come?
Well, Ritesh, being in this industry for more than 15 years, I see my work not as my work, as my passion. And this is a wonderful industry to work, and I see a lot of promising growth in the years to come. As we see, there is a rise in double income group, and there's a lot of awareness, there's a lot of exposure through media, and we have seen recently there is a growth in the pattern, the way organized malls are coming in the country. As we have seen recently, a lot of sealing and a lot of organized, you know, government taking a lot of steps towards organized spaces to be provided. If I talk generally, I would like to explain you in layman's language that this trend is going in the urban metro cities, and of course this is same is going to tier 2, tier 3 markets also. And in terms of our you know, speaking in numbers, then I see almost 25% of rising of retail industry. You know,
this even is in this the current scenario of downfall, which the industry is seeing.
I would not say this is a downfall. This is actually an era of correction. You know,
the consolidation of
maybe. Yeah, it's a consolidation patch. You know, I have the malls in the right place now. There are feasibility reports, and you know, malls are being made.
Unorganized sector is moving towards more of organizing.
Yes, can say that.
For the period in 2008-2009, there were more of IT and ITes industries were, you know, driving the market. Yes. Then there came the, you know, phase of entrepreneurship where, you know, e-commerce and, you know, logistic companies came into the demand. So what do you think, what is going to be the future now?
Now in your question lies your answer. So this e-commerce websites you talk about, so they take huge areas. You know, you talk about Amazon, Flipkart and all these, they, if you talk about Naukri.com, so they are my clients, you know, they come to me seeking out spaces, you know. And of course the IT, ITS demand has not dropped drastically, they're still there in the market. And other than that, we have other sectors also, like all your retail sectors, they have their offices. If you talk about, you know, brands like Snapdeal and all these e-commerce, they also require physical offices to manage the staffs, you know, so the demand hasn't died.
So do you think the recent policy of single brand retail, you know, 100% FDI, that nod which has come from the government, how would that impact the market?
Well, that will be again a positive factor for the international brands to enter the market, and that will go as a positive positive way.
I think it also makes more sense when, you know, all this leading Brand India campaign is going on, so I'm sure that would again bring positive.
See, again, it is positive for the single brand entities to enter. Like, for example, the IKEA has come to Hyderabad, you know, they have opened a big store here, so they are entering Delhi NCR. Something that huge, something that big is coming, and you know, people will love it. And this kind of FDI 100% allowed in India will surely be a positive step towards retail.
Being a professional, such a hectic today's lifestyle, and then you are also a busy social activist where you work for the development of girl child and girl education, how do you strike the balance, right balance between the professional and social lives?
You know, Ritesh, I am by nature very restless, so I like to keep myself very busy, and you know, the more busier I am, the more relaxed I am. So I really enjoy my work, as I told you, my work is my passion. So work I do where I'm doing this activity, where I'm helping someone. So helping again is one of my nature, and I feel very, very relaxed when I do that. So while I'm doing my women emancipation, you say it, women empowerment, you say it, when I'm doing something to help others, that's part of my nature, which kind of give me a relaxation. So that's my relaxation. My work is my passion, and my social activist, what you say, is my nature. So I like and love helping people.
That's good. I mean, making your passion your work is something that gives you
relaxation.
Being a professional in real estate for over about 15 years now, how do you think, because you hardly find very less professionals in real estate, specifically we talk about women. So how do you see the overall market has been? What do you think in terms of the potential growth?
You particularly talking about the
The perception or the reception of women professionals in real estate market. How would that impact?
Well, when I started, yes, it was difficult. I would not say it was a cakewalk. I'm a mother also. And yes, I have faced certain difficulties because ours is not a very organized sector and not very professional when it comes to certain policies. And I'm really happy I've landed in a company called ATS, which has a crutch for women. Yes, that thing is slowly going away from this industry, and people are really welcoming girls in this industry, and women are given preference. Certain, when I entered this industry, you know, the job description would always read that male candidates preferred, but now I see a change. I see female candidates preferred, and some people told me that females are better manager and they are very honest, so integrity is not an issue. So now people are welcoming the change, and I see that in their attitude also, and I'm happy to be with ATS, who really respects girls. This is a wonderful company to be. I wish I could have been here when Arun was smaller.
So, thank you for the responses, ma'am. So, this was Ms. Asma Javed, who has joined ATS as AVP, Leasing, Retail and Commercial Development. We will bring a lot of more personality to you in our next sections. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Ritesh. Nice.
Thank you.